So far in this presidential campaign, Marco Rubio's best moments have come on the debate stage.
For the life of me, I don't know why we have stigmatized vocational education. Welders make more money than philosophers. We need more welders and less philosophers.
Combine those moments with a pro-America personal story on the campaign trail.
This is not just the nation I was born in. This is the country that literally changed the history of my family. My parents were not born into a rich family. They were both born into poor families on the island of Cuba.
And you have a candidate on the rise. Behind the scenes, Democrats say they would rather not take him on in the general election.
Word on the street, inside the Hillary Clinton campaign, they are very worried about you. Should they be worried?
Well, I think if I'm the nominee, we're going to beat her. And that's one of the reasons why I chose to run for president. I believe, with all due respect, that I give our party the best chance to win this election.
With all due respect, he has a crowded field to pass, especially in Iowa, where voters get first crack. Ted Cruz, Ben Carson, Donald Trump, they're all doing well here. And Rubio knows he'll need to score with the crucial evangelical audience in the Hawkeye state.
Florida Senator Marco Rubio.
Thanksgiving week, CBN News gained exclusive access inside a private meeting with Rubio and about 100 pastors in both Cedar Rapids and Des Moines. The gathering was sponsored by the influential American Renewal Project, which works to get pastors politically engaged.
To ignore our Judeo-Christian values is to ignore the founding of our country and the principles that allowed this country to become great. This nation was founded on the belief that every person has natural rights that come from their creator. And that's where we get free enterprise, that's where we get our republic. If you don't have a creator, then what is the source of your rights? The government? The law?
Inside the room, Rubio took the opportunity to tell pastors more about himself, like his short-lived college football career.
About a year into my career there, I realized that I was destined for the National Football League, except for my lack of size, speed, and talent.
He also spoke on issues near and dear to his evangelical audience.
Today we have a president that treats Israel with less respect than what he gives the Ayatollah in Iran.
And of course, radical Islam.
If you want me to bring it to home, they believe that one day the state of Iowa will be governed, or what today is known as the state of Iowa, will be governed by Islamic law as they interpret it.
Rubio expanded on the religious nature of the conflict in our interview.
The reason why the religion part of it is important is because that is what motivates them. You have to understand what it is that is motivating someone to take action. Usually it is a geopolitical desire or a nationalistic desire. In the case of radical Islam, they are motivated by their interpretation of their faith, which they believe obligates them to kill anyone who does not accept their teachings.
Rubio also addressed a growing fear inside our country, the threat to religious liberty rights under the Constitution.
Religious liberty? It's not just the right to believe anything you want. Religious liberty is the right to live and exercise your faith in every aspect of your life.
And with social issues and moral values under attack, he believes pastors need to play a crucial role.
There's a lot of pastors and others in churches I've run into have become concerned about speaking truth on some of these issues because they don't want people to be offended in the pulpit, because they don't want to scare or drive people away. They want, you know, people want to hear happy talk sometimes and when they show up to church. But I think those that are in the pulpit have an obligation to preach truth.
And those in the pulpit also wanted to know about Rubio's spiritual truth.
Tell us about your experience with the Lord Jesus Christ, using that name.
That opening gave Rubio a chance to explain how attending an evangelical church with his wife brought his Roman Catholic faith alive.
I didn't learn about the Catholic Church until I went to a non-Catholic church and became infused in the Bible and became infused in the written word of God. And then did the liturgy of the church start even making sense.
And then we heard candidate Rubio morph into Pastor Rubio.
As far as my relationship with Jesus Christ, the best way I've been able to describe it to people that are not believers is God became a man, came down to earth, and died for our sins. He provided the ultimate sacrifice, because up to that point we lived under the law. And the law meant that we had to sacrifice an unblemished lamb to cover our sins, not erase them. God was the ultimate sacrifice. It was his own son.
That satisfied the pastor who asked the question.
I wanted to know his relationship with Jesus Christ. And boy, he had a good answer, didn't he? We're pulling pretty strong for Marco Rubio right now. Not completely there, but boy, tonight sure was a game changer.
But it wasn't an easy win. One pastor challenged him on receiving support from rich Republican donor Paul Singer, who aggressively supports same-sex marriage.
How do I know that he's not going to direct you? He's not going to sway a large amount of influence over you?
When someone cooperates with my campaign, they are buying into my agenda. I am not buying into their agenda. And that has been very clear in my history.
That seemed to do the trick.
I think my favorite line was when he said, when a donor gives money to me, they buy into me, I don't buy into them. I think that was well put.
Rubio sees this as just the beginning of his relationship with evangelicals. Hurdles will still remain, such as questions about why he teamed up with Democrats on immigration reform. But for now, Rubio is making new evangelical friends and getting prayed up in the process.
We claim the favor and wisdom and power of the Mighty One to be upon you now.
David Brody, CBN News, in Des Moines, Iowa.